This idea that it's not a Scorsese picture, you know, his name is on the credits, it's fine. So everything's okay.
You got to go another 20 minutes, though.
I don't.
To really make it.
Anthony, I swear to God, I thought this was as much bullshit as when he said that the New York Giants, which this is true, he said that the New York Giants offered him a coaching job. Come on. Come on. That's like me saying that the fucking Yankees want to make me the first baseman.
That never happened.
What the fuck?
That never happened.
It's such bullshit. But.
Wow.
We now will give you a little clip of Uncut Gems starring Adam Sandler.
Yeah, it looks good, by the way.
It does.
It looks like a good fucking movie. I didn't know Scorsese had anything to do with
it. He's a producer.
But okay, but it's got a feel.
It does.
It does have a feel.
Now, someone did point out, I wish I could give the credit on Twitter to the Twitter person, but he's like, yeah, this movie's got everything. It's got Mike Francesa as a bookie.
That's everything.
And then it's got Adam Sandler doing his best John Turturro impression.
It is John Turturro.
Yeah. It is John Turturro.
I was thinking, like, they probably wanted John Turturro. He said no. And it's like, who can we get?
That's exactly.
Oh, I could do a John Turturro. I could play the John Turturro. I just know where I have to go. John Turturro.
he gets his fucking dopey acoustic guitar and does a little song.
John Turturro, Turturro, like a bull, I fired him on.
But I swear, I was thinking the same. Like, I was thinking, they wanted Turturro.
He'd have been perfect for
it. They wanted Turturro for that role. Yeah. They just went with Sandler.
It's like, can you grow this ratty fucking Jewish beard thing?
And he's done that role before.
In what? Little Nicky?
I don't know. He's done it.
I'm Little Nicky.
We get it.
Drew, let's play the clip here, because this is amazing. I want you to wait right before we play the clip. Let me say one last thing. It's not a cameo, which I was shocked.
Wow, I thought it was a cameo.
Turturro. Adam Sandler says, Mike says something, and then Adam Sandler calls him Gary.
Yes, I thought it was going to be Mike Francesa.
So I looked it up, and it's not a cameo. Someone cast fucking Mike Francesa in a goddamn movie.
As another character. Wouldn't it be funny if he played the Mad Dog?
The Mad Dog. 12-year-old Davey Mac growing up in Jersey, who was obsessed with the Mike and the Mad Dog show. His fucking mind, his face would have melted.
It just exploded.
It just would have been a puddle of red hair on the ground.
Covenant opens, and you're fucking melting. Absolutely.
Can we please play it now, Drew? I apologize. Here.
What do you know?
I don't know. I just know.
Well, I'll tell you what I know. That's the dumbest fucking bet I ever heard of.
I disagree. I disagree, Gary.
I guess round of applause, Mike Francesa.
If he's in the trailer, then he's probably in more of the movie.
He's interesting. It looks awesome.
Yeah, they don't
because
just throw a cameo.
Because Kevin Garnett's in it, and he's actually playing Kevin Garnett, so I'm assuming it's going to be Turturro trying to get Garnett to either shave some points or throw a game. I will be saying Turturro until that movie comes out.
Do you think that's the gist that he's actually trying to get people to, like, throw games or something?
Something.
Because it looks like he's involved in some type of thing where a lot of money goes between him and other people, and he's taking that money, and instead of putting it where it's supposed to be, he's gambling.
He's running numbers.
It's almost like is it numbers?
Like, he must be running numbers.
No.
Like he's making bets with other people's money that he is supposed to give to someone else.
The mob knows that he has a connection to Kevin Garnett. Uh-huh. So the mob gets him to say, hey, throw the game to Kevin Garnett. We got $5 million. Because he knows that information, he bets big at the casino that the team's going to fuck up. The mob finds out about it because he just fucked up their bet. He lessened their payout.
Okay.
And I think that's what we're going to be seeing.
That could be it. But it does look like he's in trouble for a few bets, though, during the movie.
That's
true. It doesn't look like a one-thing deal.
No, you're right.
It looks like he's fucking up. Almost like Bad Lieutenant, the original one, where Keitel was constantly taking people's money, but not betting it for them. He was betting it like he thought he kept losing. Because the Mets are going to win. No, I know it.
Do you remember who makes... Do you remember who makes an audio cameo on Bad Lieutenant? Which is really weird. that you would bring that movie up? Because it was the first thing I thought of when I said...
It's got to be WNEW, right?
Mad Dog.
Oh, Mad Dog, right.
When Harvey
That's
Keitel
right.
was driving in the car, Mad yeah. Dog was talking about how much the fucking Mets suck.
Oh, I thought it was Mad Dog in the station wagon when he's going, show me how you suck a cock. Show me. They're like, oh, well, I grab it, I do this, I kind of jiggle it around a little bit, I suck a cock.
And show me a cock. How are you today? How are you today? It's the Mike Sucking Cock Show.
Beautiful girls coming to the Kit Kat Club. Sucking that cock.
Mad Dog's one of those guys who's got, he's got the high voice and then he's got the weird low voice. He's like, and how's everybody going? I tell you one thing right now. I have no idea. You're way better at the high Mad Dog.
That's
I do the
hilarious.
Low Mad Dog when he goes low and he's like, I can't believe the Giants are absolutely terrible. They're just great. And then when he gets excited.
Oh, yeah.
It's like,
he gets excited. Like, well, you got to give credit. You got to give credit to my Giants. A great team. A great team.
The other thing about those guys is they always used to love saying, that's a good job on your part. That's a good job on your part. So, like, they would say it all the time. One time, well, actually, they did it many years in a row where they would exchange Christmas presents.
Oh,
and
shit.
One time, because Mad Dog is a San Francisco Giants fan.
Yeah, San Francisco
Why,
Giants.
He grew up in Long Island.
Makes no sense.
No one fucking knows that. But anyway... Mike gives him a San Francisco ugly as sin sweater. It actually looked like it was one of those like ugly sweater contest
yeah,
sweaters.
Yeah, just a piece
goes,
of shit.
Oh my god, a giant sweater. That's a good job on your part, Mike.
Good job on your part.
As if Mike just, you know, went 4-for-6 in a doubleheader for the Yankees.
That's great.
Can you be a human and not rely on your goddamn sports cliches for a second? With shit like the bottom line and this idea.
That's
is...
good. You really brought your present game face today.
But I heard that, I don't know if Mad Dog wants to chime in at all, but I actually heard that, Mike, you can keep going, Roy. This is going to be a big thing for him.
Really?
Well, apparently, let me just see. He's now been offered a role in the next Star Wars movie.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow, that's fast. Yeah. That's a fast progression.
Kylo Ren is the guy I'm going to be, you know, Sith Lord kind of apprentice type, you know, this idea that, you know, the lightsaber is jagged. It's jagged. I mean, you know, this idea that you can't afford a proper lightsaber, you know, nice, smooth lightsaber, there's sparks flying everywhere. You know, I'm going to become Kylo Ren, but I will say this, you know, there's going to be a few changes. Mike Francesa, Hung Star, is here. And then, you know, Anthony, Mad Dog, they offer me another Jurassic World. I'm going to be playing one of the T-Rexes, you know, the large fat man. You know, some people will call it typecasting, this idea that, you know, I've been drinking Diet Cokes and trying to lose weight, you know, and people keep pointing out my robust waistline.
You don't want to fall asleep if there's T-Rexes running around, I'll tell you that much.
That's a good point, though.
Hey, spill a Diet Coke, I hear that some of those little dinosaurs very attracted to sugar.
Okay, this
you gotta watch it.
This idea that there's sugar involved, and Mad Dog is yelling at me.
Why does Kylo Ren have those two things coming out of his lightsaber? Doesn't make sense. How does it work?
You'd think one of the little swords would hit his hands or something.
Little nut makes, you know, no
when,
sense.
When you got the two the things there, the cross, what do they call that? The laser crossbar.
It's like a hilt. If the sword's hilt gets hit with another lightsaber, the fucking metal's gonna come off. I understand if the whole thing is part of a lightsaber, but it's got metal on it.
You know, don't
come right through it.
He raises a good point for a change. I mean, this idea that, you know, there's a tilt and, you know, the sparks are flying. I mean, you know, Dog doesn't have a good point all the time, but this on this part. And, you know,
see that new fold-out one?
The full now they made a lightsaber with nunchucks. And it doesn't seem like a very applicable type of weapon, if you're gonna ask me. It seems like you know, just go with the old school sword.
You don't have to get carried away with these things. But I gotta make lightsaber Chinese stars.
I mean, first of all, Doug, how would one throw those things?
Very dangerous, the lightsaber.
Second, you picked up one of the Chinese lightsaber stars, it'd probably cut your fingers off.
I think there'd be more Jedis without hands. Quite frankly, I pick up a knife every so often, I cut myself. That thing's gonna destroy your hands. It's gonna cut it right off.
They'd be very nubby, you know. Luke Skywalker would have this type of thing.
Get my stock in the mechanical hand industry.
And they would have to probably put a pen in Luke Skywalker's hand like he was Bob Dole or something.
Let go, Bob Dole!
And it would be like very embarrassing for the rest of the galaxy.
Should be a safety on that thing. And they pull it out, the fucking thing comes right out. What if it's on your hip and it hits the button? Your leg's gone.
And these X-Wings flying around, like this idea that, you know, the spaceship and they're shooting lasers all over the place. And what, we're supposed to believe that they can hit people? I saw episode 7, the Poe, Edgar Allan Poe Dameron was shooting lightsabers hitting stormtroopers. I mean, am I buying this idea that this is reasonable? Not so much.
Why did the bombers have to fly so slow? They got hyperspace. Just fly real fast, drop your bombs, and get the fuck out of there.
It's an excellent point. I mean, quite frankly, that Chinese girl, the one who died, is the one who should have been in the movie, and not not the janitor girl who no one cares about.
And the other one. I the see one, that girl at the Chinese the buffet up the street.
The good one. The good one the should good have been. The good one.
The good one who was fighting, who was, you know, tapping the thing. I gotta get the thing. I gotta drop the bombs. Everyone's screaming at her. She dropped the bombs. She was a hero. She was like Joan of Arc in space.
And now, instead, we got some locksmith. We got Schneider from the fucking, you know,
Too Close for Comfort.
One day at a time.
One day at a time. Whatever the fucking show was. Too Close for Comfort was a guy with a cow or something like that. I forget what the hell he was. He was a cartoonist.
Yes.
Ted Knight. Okay.
With his foodie sidekick.
And then, you know, at the other thing, excuse me, Mad Dog. That's your name for the segment. You know, I'm not sure you're aware, but Quentin Tarantino's planning to make Pulp Fiction 2. And I'm going to be trying out for the role of Samuel Jackson. You know, like, this idea that Ezekiel says, proverbs.
What a long
bunch
speech.
Bunch of proverbs and things, and I am the way of the Lord, I am the shepherd. And then we
could
shoot
you shoot
guy.
Me already? Could you fucking shoot me already?
It's like, you know, he's like, is Marcellus Wallace's, do you want to fuck Marcellus's wife? Something like that. And stop saying the stop saying what over and over again. I forget exactly how it goes.
It's called the Royale with cheese, Mikey.
Royale
with cheese.
They do things in Europe that, you know, this idea that they can't use a proper metric system. I mean, let's be honest, America did create the quarter pounder, and the fact that they have to change its name.
The editor's gonna have to be brilliant on this fucking film.
I mean, the other thing that I'm not sure if you're aware of this, but Doc, they're gonna do a sequel to Do the Right Thing.
Oh, wow. And you're gonna be in that.
I'm gonna be the guy Danny Aiello's part. I'm gonna be like, hey, welcome to Mike's Pizzas. You know, and the big black comes in with the boombox. And I'm like, okay, could you turn it down, please? You know, I'm trying to do a movie here, and, you know, Spike Lee's over there. And then all of a sudden, he's like, I don't want to, there's no Italians on the wall.
Right.
And then, you know, all of a sudden, it's like, okay, this idea that I got to put, Sammy Davis Jr. next to Frank Sinatra.
Did they do that clip where they drag you like you're on a skateboard? That whole scene that he likes to do in movies. I never got that. What are they floating? What are they doing? They're like the Great Gazoo in Flintstones.
That one, yeah. Well, I mean, that's my next picture. It's gonna be Back to the Future 4. I'm gonna play the part of Doc Brown. Be like Marty, something about the gigawatts. You know, I don't know the exact number, but you know, you do the research. Mike doesn't want to do a lot of show prep. Mike comes in here. Mike rocks the mic. Okay, it's Mike's
talking
on.
Talking to third person.
It's back to the mic's up. Is what it's on. So the other thing that they were gonna do is like a sequel of Dances with Wolves. It was like, look at all these Indians running around. And it's like, you know, I'm not sure. Should I be shooting them? Should I be joining them? Are we actually gonna be dancing with wolves?
You must have really been auditioning a lot. You picked up every fucking audition. You got the part.
I mean, I know you're a dog, so a dog is close to the wolf in terms of lineage and animal, you know, ancestry.
Can you get me the part in the movie then? I'll play the wolf.
But my point is, I mean, Chris.
No!
I mean, okay, that's a good job on your part, dog, you know, with that impression. you know, this idea that, like, you know, it feels a little dangerous, you know, the wolves, I'm dancing with them, it's like, what is it, like a Macarena or a YMCA?
I believe it's a waltz, Maggie. I believe you dance a waltz with a wolf.
Wouldn't you expect to get bitten at that point? You know, they have Giants defense. I don't really understand what that is.
Maybe babies, too. Very disturbing.
And then the other thing is, like, I'm not sure if you're aware of this, but Woody Allen's going to make a sequel to Annie Hall, and it's like, I'm going to do that one part is like, Jew eat. And that's what he said. He said, no, it's not like he said, did you eat? Okay? This idea that he said, did you eat? Okay? But he muddled his words. He said, Jew eat. Okay? This idea.
Sounds a little anti-Semitic to me, Mikey.
Roy Harder would know all about that. Roy, what do you think?
He's from Austria.
Count me out of this conversation, please, David.
You know, I'm not sure you're with it, Sam. They're going to make a sequel to E.T., and it's like the fingers are touched. It's like, what's going to happen in the next one? You always got to up the ante, so maybe what? Like a dick's touch? And it's like, Elliot's like 42 years old, and, you know, E.T. has an alcohol problem. They're touching dicks on Times Square to get like $20 or something. They're like street performance artists, you know, like in like a cowboy scenario, you know, two-man.
So you want to destroy children's memories?
I mean, in a way, I suppose it could be rated R. And this idea that everything's got to be for children's is, you know, a little bit preposterous. Anyway, I'm Mike Francesa. That's Anthony Christopher Mad Dog Russo.
Fuck Mike you, and the Mad Dog Show.
Fuck you, America.
Fuck you, America.
Oh, I didn't know he's getting so many parts.
He is going to get a lot of parts.
Crazy
now.
For this.
His movie career is going to take off.
A whole new career for Mike Francesa.